So now finally the result is done and the groundwork some sort is finished. I mean, I'm getting result of my model. So basically today I wrote test for the bucket model. You see actually the output of my bucket model, it's pretty good if you compare it with where is my, so you, if you compare the file, the result, the output result with the buckets, you can clearly, you can clearly see that is here. For example, I have German satellites, so for example let me just take this channel. And this channel has name, he has ID, he has transponder ID, and he has ONIT. ONIT is, where is ONIT? Let me just check it. Set, yeah, transponder ONIT here, 001. So all things are good. One problem was it with channels without names, like this list for example. I filtered this out during the process of creating a channel. So basically here I have my set TV channel builder, bucket channel builder, and this actually makes sure, this line makes sure that I have only, that I'm reading only valid attributes of my channel, and this is actually invalid attributes because it's basically radio channels. But my program does not it was not planned to read radio channels from satellite. So yeah, and next funny thing, it was like thinking about, like for example here I have code of reading JDOM document and I'm just repeating the same code in my bucket model class, but nevertheless it work and it is fully tested. Let me just run all of my tests. And basically I think I did completed the groundwork. Now I can, let me just run my test, all my tests. Now I can read XML. From XML I creating Java objects, Java model objects, and after that I can work with all of my objects which I have created. So you see, this is a result from the building my bucket set, my set TV bucket set, and now I have 107 unit tests. So basically a lot of unit tests, but this is was expected, and throughout of the project it helped me a lot. It is not yet finished because I need to think about UI, how exactly UI will look. But before I actually go to the UI itself, I need to think about to work with operations. Like now I have established my models, and now I need to think how my models will interact with each other. Do I need to check out values from my services XML and check them with the values of my bucket model? Or if I add information in my set model, what should I add to my set services model? Things like that. After doing things like that, I need to think about what I actually think thinking about adding a new channel to my bucket and how I will actually do it. And after I done my CRUD operations, so basically test case, add to the favorite group some channel and then update the model, then delete from the favorite group and search in the favorite group, and basically after read, delete, update, create basic CRUD operations and search, of course I would like to have a search method. I need to actually after I covered this, I need to go to the thinking about to creating an outputter, XML outputter class. So basically now where I have my Java objects, now I need to create some output. The output is of course an XML, and basically my program actually will create bucket XML, satellite XML, and services XML. It will generate all of this information from the Java objects. And after doing this, I can only, so basically work, I will work at CRUD, then I will work at outputting the information, and then I know how to output the information from the Java objects, and then I can actually work at UI interface, and UI interface is just plugin for me. So basically it will work with the design pattern of model view controller, and basically another milestone is reached. Thanks to the TDD, I was able to manage today to be very productive and very successful. So this is the end of my today's coding session. I hope you learn a lot, and I hope to see you in my next coding session. Thank you and bye-bye. Okay, so this is the second part. I lost some of my footage today. It was a little bit hot today, but anyway, let me just quickly walk you through what I have done today. I created my set buckets builder test. This test is responsible for creating and testing the class which creates actually a set of set TV buckets. And I did show it to you previously in my video that it is all runs very good and I'm getting actual results. So basically this method checks if I can create and set up this some sort of a sorted set. The sorted set itself, I'm getting here the method here, I'm checking is this not empty, so I'm actually getting the values from the builder, from the class where I create this set, and now I just check it and it works pretty well. So let me just run only one test and then run a JUnit test. And it runs without any problem. Yeah. And this is actually builder class. So I'm getting from my JDOM document all needed values. I'm verifying these values. It was like for the attribute locate and the hidden. So hidden can be only 0 or 1, and the same goes to the locate. And then I assign these values and build a bucket. And my bucket model is pretty simple. Let me just close it all. Bucket model. And you see I have structure and order in my project. So basically here is all of my models which I use in the class. And here is a model, set bucket TV channel. Actually I need to call this model. And this model consists of reading JDOM document, checking if the JDOM document was read successfully by my class. And then I have here a method which can actually verify it. But most important method is here, build set of buckets. So here once again I'm, before I can create a set of buckets, I need to verify that my JDOM document is not empty, and I'm doing here and building actually my buckets set of my buckets. And yeah, and if you see, if you run all of the tests, Maven test, I have 109 tests throughout my project. So basically it's preparing my it compiles if it need to compile something, copy some stuff if it need to compile. Now it runs my test and see it is pretty fast, 107 tests which I have created. And for each of the model and the builder class you have appropriate test, and this is how it should be done. This is how I am actually, this actually was important for me to develop my project in such a way. My project is not yet complete, but anyway, I reached another milestone. Interesting part was when I worked with my, where it is, my resources. Interesting part was when I worked with my bucket XML. So here for example, here for example you have a bucket with a radio channels, and my project is not about reading and managing radio channels. So I did not check it my XML, verified my XML for this part, but when I hit the problem that my builder class for my bucket many times fails, I did figure out that it was because of my bucket's XML. And then I just make sure that I'm, when I'm reading my channels, that I'm only reading valid channel lines. So it should have 5 attributes, not 4. And that was very important. And the same I'm doing when I'm creating my bucket. I'm always checking it. So pretty safe with what I have done. And what I additionally can say, like for example some stuff which I repeat, I'm not so like it that is repeating. So for example here I'm reading from JDOM document 2 times, one time in this class same code, and one time in this class same code, I mean in the model. Let me just open it, set bucket model. So yeah, same code, I'm reading JDOM document. So my XML reader, it just gets the path from where it should read an XML. It gets hold of an XML file and creates from the XML file the JDOM document. And here I'm just calling this class and getting my XML JDOM document. So basically it makes some concern. And another stuff about validation, basically for some of the stuff I have here, not here, I mean in my set channel bucket channel, I think it is here. So some class I have validators, so I need to validate some stuff. I think it is like here, maybe validate. So maybe at some point I will move my stuff where I validate the data in another class. I did use it actually. I created a validate set data, which is responsible for validating some stuff, which I use in many my classes. So I'm trying to reduce code usage, but sometimes it's not so obvious for me, and sometimes I prefer and like to write some more code, but it is all tested. This is the main point. It is all tested, and I hope you can read it. And if you don't like it, the project is on the GitHub. You can always refactor it, work with it. But I think it is better to collaborate on the project and just reach the milestones and be happy about that it's working. So I'm pretty satisfied with my today's result. Next part, as I told earlier, it will be about CRUD operations, about validating and consistency of the data. And after doing that, I will work with outputting my result to the XML file without GUI. But then when I have created such classes which actually can output the data in XML, I can work with my UI. So then I will work basically with JavaFX. And let me just quickly show my thinking pattern. So basically my plan is pretty simple. I will just write some I don't know, here I have my controller, and here I have my UI elements, and here I have my model. And basically the controller decides when to write to my model, and UI gets the input from the user, and my controller analyzes it, responds back with updated data to the UI. UI show the information to the user, and things like that. So and UI itself, I'm not so big front-end developer, but I like when I have the time to think about UI, that this should be pretty user friendly, so that you can do some stuff with it. So you saw my mock-up picture there, where I have my, I don't know, like panel presentation. So I'm not actually have full design of layouts of my future UI, but I'm thinking about like doing following, like reserving here the place for the search, and here list all of my channels which I can read from the services, and here I just represent my buckets. And basically for me, buckets are structured in a way that you have things like tabs. I mean, if you use Firefox browser as me, I have here tabs, so I can quickly switch over from one tab to another and then populate the data here. So basically it will be very interesting stuff with a representation of my information. But I have the tools, and basically I will use the format of FXML. Why you ask? Because it is some sort of easy way. I have Sceni Builder, which is a UI designer. My it's not strong my skill to draw. I'm not an artist. So basically my UI designer will generate FX XML from which I will produce my objects, Java objects. So I have here like FXML lowdown, things like that. I'm not sure how it is. I mean, I'm not sure how it is another setup and what is the life cycle of all of these parts, but I know where to look and how to connect them. I have a lot of examples how to do that, and I'm actually not seeing this like a big. After working with XML, I think all is easy. And if you saw my videos, you probably agree with me. But anyhow, this is, will be like this. UI designer Sene Builder creates FXML, and I'm loading this FXML, and just after doing so, I can add to this Sene. I mean to the UI layout, I can add dynamically additional elements, and this should probably maybe will be some sort of a challenge, but I don't think that this will be big challenge as it can be compared with the working with XML. But now when I'm almost done with XML, I think I will be even more faster with all of other. So stay tuned and see you next then. Have a nice day. Bye bye.